So this game and the next one are, well, the first one's a bit weird, but I think they kind of illustrate one of the drawbacks to changing up the disruption suite in the deck to duresses, which is that. So I've talked a lot of crap about the traditional blue decks in Vintage, and I think I really don't like them right now. I think that a lot of the cards that have been added to the format for the last few years have been very spiteful to them. But if you're showing up with Storm, that is a fight that they've been built to fight. Is, you know, I have a few more counters than you, and I don't actually think they're that good in the matchup, but they can definitely win just on the basis of you don't have forces and they, or they have forces, you don't, and there are games where their hands come together in a busted way, such that Storm doesn't really have anything it can do about them. But that's not game one. Game one's a bit weird. This hand is perfectly reasonable to keep. It's basically 5 plus 2 randoms, and I would gladly take this 5 plus 2 randoms. So fire off probe. We see brick to pitch to force, brainstorm, mana, thought cast, and will. So he's not really going anywhere, but we do have to fight through this force and probably whatever he finds out the brainstorm. So we draw a wheel. So there's the decision about whether just to use this wheel to burn the force. But the thing you have to realize is that the game one configuration of this deck doesn't have a red mana to find that also taps for Preordain in a turn or walk in a turn. So that's kind of loose. I opt to just go with the Preordain, try to set my hand more. See. The duress doesn't. The duress fights through. His force here, but I still don't have anything to do if I keep it. The tutor gets me. I mean, the tutor basically does the same thing as the duress, because he's just going to force it or whatever I get. I probably should have kept at least one of them. I remember, because this chat is terrible, I'm pretty sure that we shipped both. Yep, we drew Necro, which is absurdly punishing for us. I think if I keep one, there's a chance that I can, like, duress his force. And then start like walking into something, but I don't. I drop the mana rocks here because I want the maximum amount of mana next turn to do things. Though I guess I don't actually have to play the crypt here. My thought was that I might be able to Hercules and do some stuff, but if I go see crypt ring, that's and draw a red source, I get to go. One, so this goes one mana, three mana, minus one is two, four, and then one is five, so I'd still have enough for wheel walk. So I didn't actually have to expose the crypt here. It's definitely going to cost me in the end. So the rule of the game is tails never fails. So because of my extreme luck, I did not get punished. So I lead on Time Walk as a bit of counter bait. There's a lot of times where the blue deck just kind of has to counter. Well, I guess they'd have to counter the follow-up. But, like, it's not a good state if the Storm player gets to resolve a draw 7 after a Time Walk because it's untap with all of this mana in play. And I guess it's the other reason to do that. Drop these. Not everyone went through the math on that. That was just stupid. So Time Walk resolves. I'm going to hold my Sapphire in case I get to use it to set up a Storm spell. I lose the flip once. Again, the awkward interaction of Time Walk plus Mana Crypt. And I think I may have mistimed this Mystical. Though I guess I'd rather hold it so I can decide what to get based on what he does. Rather than like giving him another draw step to hit, the misstep isn't huge. So I take another 3 damage. I Mystical for the unbeatable card, Mind's Desire. And I definitely messed this turn up because he knows about the Desire. Because he's just going to counter this Hercules. Though I guess that's not the worst use, is that it turns Hercules into a Duress. I have to play the Sapphire first for the record because I need to get the extra blue out of it by Hercules-ing it. Yeah, he brainstorms here pretty obviously. And at this point, I have to worry about if he can set up a Yawgwhal for something that matters. Though, to be fair, just a brainstorm isn't quite enough. The crypt is a little scary. And all he has is a thought cast, though. It taps him out. I debate the disgusting option of casting Mind's Desire for one. That sounds terrible. And instead, Vamp. Looking to set up a play next turn. We're going to open this up in preemptiveness of next turn. So he looks to be some kind of... I don't really buy this kind of mana base. I think if you're going to be thought casting, you have to be playing Seed of the Synod, which cuts enough lands out of your deck that I don't think you can play fetches, but I could be wrong. Tails wins the flip. So we get Lotus with the Vamp, which is, again, if you're not going to get Desire, if you're not going to get Recall, you're probably going to get something like this. So I lead on Wheel on the basis that I'm pretty sure he has to counter it, which adds one to my Desire Storm count, especially because it puts me up like three cards on him. So we end up Desiring for three, which honestly is sometimes enough in this format. Oh, four. I can't count. What's the fourth spell this turn? Oh, the Lotus. I am terrible at counting. Four is certainly enough a lot of the time. I feel like something's lying to me here. So in a lovely example of the weirdest thing I've seen on V4 lately, that just doesn't work. My flip was definitely nothing of the sort, because that was actually lethal if I had flipped two Rituals, Jet, Tendrils, and the Necro in my hand. It was pretty much a bunch of garbage, and I was forced to pass the turn. And what ends up happening is that I actually get to Duress him. I take his Will, so he can't kill me. But I see a Lightning Bolt, and I end up dying to my own Mana Crypt plus his Lightning Bolt before I can do anything. Unfortunate. But I think this game may illustrate some of the issues a bit better. So I think this hand is fine because it's just the Gunnet with Wheel hand. So I get to do my broken thing. He has the Force. We'll just get that out of the way. I decide the best course of action is to cycle the walk and try to get somewhere before he establishes drain mana. Unfortunately, Necropotence is not quite somewhere. So Ancestral Recall happens. My opponent has all the cards in his hand. And discards for the turn, which is a very bad sign for me. Because look at all this. How am I supposed to fight that? I decide the correct course of action. I mean, besides running out of things. That was Drain, Fluster, Fluster, Pyroblast, Snapcaster for those watching. I'm going to try to get to a point where I can resolve this Necro before he hits a land. That does not work out well. He time walks. And now is the point where he can actually just cast Snapcaster into Recall. Which immediately happens. Yeah. Immediately sets up Key Vault, and there is nothing I can do. So the kind of thing you saw is that I did my busted thing. My hand waffled about a bit just because of the mana, which happens less for my deck than his deck. But because he has the interaction that prevents me from just like going busted on him on the start, there are situations where he gets to slow me down a little bit and just have his busted draw. I don't think it's actually as common as some people think it is, but it definitely can happen. It's definitely a weakness of this deck, as opposed to something like Steel City Vault, for what it's worth.